Hi there, welcome to this learner's video on a very exciting topic of mass spectrometry, and I'm thrilled to bring it to you on an all-new dynamic and interactive platform of Prezi Video. The scope of this video is in trying to understand whether we can determine a molecular formula of the organic compound using its mass spectrum, and as it turns out, the answer is yes. Let's see how. Now, before we delve into all the empirical rules that are available to determine molecular formula of an organic compound, let's just recapitulate some basics about a mass spectrum.
Can I say this is where it all starts, where both the right and the left circularly polarized light are at the same place to begin with, right?
Yes.
All start like this. Time elapses,
yes.
As it propagates, you will have both of them moving in opposite directions. So say for example,
at
T1, they both moved a certain angle from the mean position.
Intensity 1 is to 3 is to 3 is to 1 and so on. If we move one step further to look at the coupling constants involved in such type of coupling and compare it with the coupling constants in H1 NMR, we see that when we record an H1 NMR and there are two different nuclei in different magnetic environments, they couple with one another, giving a certain coupling constant that's usually in the range of 1.
The golden rule still remains that when you want to look at the acid strength, what do you look for? You look for the stability of the conjugate base. HA dissociates to give H plus and A minus. The more stable the conjugate base A minus is, the more acidic the acid HA will be, right? This was the